Hello. In this WAGO tutorial, we will show you how to create markers manually, add different elements and edit them in Smart Script. First, we start with a new project and want to mark a strip with item number 2009110. The button grid on the Insert tab opens the editor window for the terminal block marking. First, we define the format. We want to label two rows, so we add another row via the Add Row button. The lower row should now label five individual terminal blocks, so we divide them into five parts. With Add, we add this setup to the project. The next terminal block section is also double rowed, but via seven terminal blocks, and we want to put an end plate at the end. So we check the box for end plate and confirm with Add. Now we can label the strip in the project window. We call the first section Room 1 and the second Room 2. We mark Room 1 with 1, 2, 3, N and PE. You could also label the individual terminal blocks of Room 2, but we do this here with the AutoNum function. To do this, we have to mark the bottom row of the second section. For that, we click on the second section, then a blue bar appears at the left edge of the section, with which we can reduce the selection to the lower ranges by a simple click. Now we open the AutoNum window with the button AutoNum. First, we activate the Live Preview switch and then assign the initial value under Start Value and the final value for End Value, for example from 4 to 10. The pre-selection is shown in green and we confirm with Apply. We will discuss the AutoNum function in more detail later, but we first want to save the marking of the first section as a template so we can use it in other projects. To do this, we first select the section by left-clicking and open the context menu by right-clicking on the section and select Save to Collection. Select Folder, assign a file name and save. To use this template, go to the Insert tab, open the grid window and find the saved template under Collection. Select and add the template and we can edit the new section as needed. For example, adjust the name and add an end plate via the Grid tab. If a smart printer with cutter is used, cut marks can also be set. These can be set in the Project Properties tab. We activate the cut marks by clicking Cut Marks and can add a cut mark using the arrow button. The first cut mark is placed all the way to the left, since the strip is printed from right to left and is to be cut at the latest. Additional cut marks can be set via Add Cut, which we can then set at the desired points. If cut marks are set and we want to print on a smart printer without a cutter, an error message appears. To print without an error message, we can simply disable the cut marks by clicking the arrow button. This means that we do not have to delete the cut marks from the project and can activate them again when a cutter is available again. To immerse yourself even more deeply in the topic of editing, we now show some functions using the type plate as an example. We are creating a new project with item number 2.10, 804 type plates, 99 to 44 millimeter silver. We start in the Insert tab by clicking on text and inserting a text box. We drag it to the desired position and adjust the size of the text box via the corner marker. We label the text box and can edit the text in the Home tab. In our case, it should not be bold and aligned left. We can now copy and paste this text box as often as needed and edit them as shown. In this text box, we now need the DC symbol, and we can find this and other standard electrical symbols in the Insert tab in the Symbols area. At the top right, we now add another text box and label it. However, this should now be without a frame. The border area in the Home tab is the place to edit it. We uncheck the box and the frame has been removed. Below that, we add another text box with the internet address, since it should be in a different text format. The CE mark must not be missing and we insert it directly from the symbols and edit it accordingly. The logo is available as an image file and we add it via the image button. we also want to print the serial number as a QR code. To do this, open the barcode window using the barcode button and then select the required code format. Enter the serial number and add it to the type plate using add. If the QR code is selected, the barcode tab at the top menu bar appears and shows the value in the QR code. Our type plate has been edited as far as possible, and we want to protect the design against accidental editing. To do this, we select everything with Ctrl plus A and can use the lock above the browser column to secure all elements, which is indicated by a closed green lock. If we now try to move the elements or change their size, it's no longer possible. However, we can still change the content. To also save the content, such as the company address or designations, which always remain the same, we mark these elements and click on the lock again. This is now shown in red, which also protects the content of the elements. Number. Since it makes no sense to print multiple type plates with the same serial number, the autonum function also makes sense here. The serial number is contained in two fields, as a digit and as a QR code, so we mark the two fields and open the autonum window. We entered the existing serial number as the start value and want to create multiple type plates with leading numbers from 20 to 30, so we enter the serial number with a 30 at the end as the end value. Before we confirm with apply, we still activate the switch for automatic extension of elements, which then creates a new type plate for each new series number. However, when we confirm with apply, only 6 type plates are created, and it looks like every second serial number is always skipped. Now let's take a look at the QR codes, and we'll find the missing serial numbers here. So the auto number function has written the serial number sequentially over all marked fields. We delete the wrong type plates and try again. We can retain the entries that have already been made, but now enter a 2 for repetition per value. This repeats each serial number once. Mark both fields with serial number. Confirm with apply, the type plates are created and we have a consecutive serial number once as numbers and correspondingly as QR code. The every xth value functions also function similarly. For example, if a 2 is entered here, every second number is skipped and we only receive even serial numbers here. We show the interrupts function in the autonum window, again using the example of a marking strip for terminal blocks. To do this, we create a new project with the 2009-110 strip. Select the two row under project properties and want to create 50 rooms with 5 terminal blocks each, so we create an upper and a lower area. Divide the upper area into 50 parts, and to get 5 parts each in the lower area, we divide the lower area into 250 parts. Now we open the window autonum and mark the top section, can check the box for live preview and create sections from room 1 to room 50. We then want to number individual terminal blocks through at the 4th and 5th place, however, the numbering should be interrupted by a N and a PE terminal block. So we enter a start value of 1 and an end value of 150 and check the box for interrupts. Now we enter the number of elements to be numbered before the interruption, in our case 3 elements, and in the box below, we specify what should be written in the interruption, in this case N. To label the ground terminal block as well, we can add another interrupt element with the small green plus and label it with PE. If we now confirm with apply all terminal blocks from 1 to 150, including N and PE terminal blocks, are labeled.